Good morning, Jonah.
Good morning, Brandon. How are you?
I'm great. How are you, brother?
I am really good today. How was your week?
I had an amazing week. How was yours?
I had a great week. I hope you had a great week, too. Welcome to Kids City, a ministry of City Baptist Church. We're so glad you joined today, and I hope you had a great week helping your parents out, being kind one to another, and also praying and reading your Bibles. Hope you were doing that.
Yeah, I hope so too. Those are all very important things. So guys, like you said, we have a great lesson ahead of us. We have a new devotional video. We have a great, fun weekly challenge.
Yeah.
But guys, before all of that,
all right,
we are about to sing some worship songs.
Let's do it.
Okay, so wherever you are in your house, on your bed, on your couch, let's get up, okay? And let's sing some songs. Let's worship.
To them, what a beautiful name it is, the God created each of us for specific reasons, but one of the most important ones is to tell others about Jesus Christ and how to receive salvation through belief in Him. The Apostle James warned that we shouldn't be eager to be teachers of God's Word because we will be held to a higher standard. We all fail in many areas, especially with our words. But it is possible to learn to control our words so that they reflect our beliefs and God's mission for our lives. As an example, James tells us that horses don't start out their lives as gentle, trained animals. They are wild creatures with huge, powerful bodies. But with some training and something as small as a bit and bridle in their mouths, we can control the direction in which these massive animals go. By controlling our words, we can control the power and direction of our lives as well. James continues describing how sailing ships are amazing. They can cross huge bodies of water and carry enormous loads of supplies. Though these vessels are driven by fierce winds, they can be directed by a tiny rudder steered by a single person at the helm. We can accomplish great things and persevere in stormy times if we can control the words we speak. The tongue we use to speak is small, but in many ways, it is the most dangerous part of our bodies. James tells us that just as a tiny spark can set a whole forest on fire, a single evil word the tongue spits out can start a destructive fire that can do unimaginable damage. However, just as our words can corrupt our lives and stir up all kinds of evil, they can also do incredible good. Next, James has us consider animals. From reptiles to birds, creatures of the sea to beasts of the jungle, humans have tamed and trained every kind of animal on Earth. The only thing humans have been unable to tame are their own tongues to keep them from speaking evil. It has deadly potential to spew out poison-filled words, wounding all who hear them. Consider this. On Sunday, we go to church where we use our tongues to speak and sing praises to God, and then a few hours later, we speak words that curse another person who was made in God's image. One minute, our tongues are doing what they were created to, and the next, they are acting out of evil. This should never be. Good and evil cannot come from the same place. Can an apple tree bear oranges, or a saltwater pond produce fresh water? No. So a Christian should not use evil words. Our words should honor God and reflect a godly life. The Bible tells us that Jesus was the Word of God who became flesh. Jesus is our example to follow, and our lives should speak and live out the good words of God.
City, I hope you're having a good Sunday so far, and we miss seeing your faces, but we're glad that we can connect this way. So today I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about our words and the things that come out of our mouths and how we can use our speech to be honoring the Lord and how we could use it to encourage others. So I have an acronym for you, and an acronym is just, I'll show you right now. My acronym is the word THINK. Okay, and we all know how to spell the word THINK, T-H-I-N-K. So in the word THINK, the T stands for truth. Okay, so we want to make sure that the things that come out of our mouths are things that are true. Okay, we all know the Ten Commandments, and one of the commandments is that we should not bear false witness to our neighbors. So that just means we shouldn't lie to our friends, we shouldn't lie to our family, we should just always be honest in the things that we say, okay? And the next letter in the word THINK is H, okay? And H stands for helpful. So is what you're saying in the moment helpful? okay? Is it edifying? Edifying just means, is it encouraging, okay? To encourage someone is so important, and we need to use our speech to encourage the people that we're around, okay? And you know how good it feels when somebody says something and it encourages you, okay? So you would want to be the same to somebody else. You would want to encourage them as well with your words, okay? And after H, if you all know how to spell, is, if I can open my thing, is the letter. Letter I, okay? And I stands for, is it inspiring or does it influence the person that you're talking to do the right thing? Is it, are you encouraging or you're influencing the person to be kind to somebody else who doesn't get a lot of kindness, okay? It's important that our words lead people to do the right thing, okay? And then the next letter, if I can work my little thing here, is N. Okay, and N means, stands for necessary or needful. So is what is coming out of our mouth, is it necessary? Is that something that needs to be said in the moment, okay? And sometimes we might be in a situation where we just get really upset or really angry and then something just comes out of our mouth, okay? It happens to everybody, okay? And I want to show you a little video clip right now about a little friend here who has some very, very good advice for us, okay? So let's watch this video clip quickly.
If you can't say something nice, don't say nothing at all.
Okay, so we all watched little Thumper there, and he is learning that if he doesn't have anything nice to say, he shouldn't say anything at all. Okay, and that's true for us, for kids, for adults. If we don't have something nice to say, we just don't need to say it. Okay, and the last letter is K. Okay, now can you guess what the letter K stands for? Okay, the letter K stands for kind. So before you speak, is what is coming out of your mouth going to be something that is kind? Okay, we want to be kind to the people around us, okay? And right now, because we're social distancing, who are the people around us? The people around us are our family, mom, dad, brothers and sisters. And honestly, sometimes it's your family that kind of sees the worst side of you because they're your family and you know that they love you and that they'll always forgive you. But that's not an excuse to use unkind words to them, okay? So right now, what I want you to do is look at the screen or whatever you're watching on the TV, the computer, the iPad, and stick your little tongue out. But you can only stick it out at me right now, okay? Nobody else around you, okay? Have you all done that? Okay, so if you stick out your tongue, I just want you to do that because I want you to see how small the tongue is compared to the rest of your body, okay? The tongue is what we use to speak. Okay, and in the Bible, there are so many verses that talk about our tongue, okay? And the tongue is a very small part of our body. And in James chapter 3, it says that a tongue that's such a small member in our body can cause so much trouble. We can say mean things, we can make fun of somebody, we can yell at somebody. There's just so much damage or bad that our mouth and our tongue and our speech can do to the people around us. So instead of being unkind and untruthful and dishonest and not nice to the people around us. So before you speak, think, okay? Is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring or is it influential into someone's life to influence them to do the right thing? Is it necessary and is it kind? Okay, I want you guys to think about that. Think on that for this week, okay? Think. Okay, we miss you guys so much and I hope that you guys have a good rest of your Sunday. Bye.
All right, guys, the cool thing is I actually live really close to Simon, so I can hand deliver this. So we're gonna see if he is home and we can give him his prize. All right, here we go. Hi, Simon.
Hey.
Say hi to Kid City.
Hi, Kid City.
Hi, Rachel.
Hello.
Good job. Hey, guys, I just want to say congratulations. Thanks for participating in the challenge. You did a great job. And this week's winner is Simon.
Thank you.
All right, well, you get a choice of one of the two prizes there. So you can take a look at them and you can decide which one.
Can you pick two
for us? No, just one, unfortunately. There's an Uno game and one is a, looks like a brain teaser, like a puzzle. It's called an IQ Buster.
I'll take this.
All right, sounds good. Well, thank you guys. And make sure you guys participate in this week's challenge, all right? All right, bye guys.
Bye. See ya.
Hi, Kid City. It's Brother Jules here to bring you this week's challenge. You know, I was thinking about this week. One thing I love is art. So this week, the challenge is going to be an art challenge, okay? Another thing I love is my parents. You know, and you should love your parents too. And I'm pretty sure you guys do. If you think about it, parents are super awesome. Like, I mean, they take care of you. Literally, without them, you guys are nothing. Really, we're all nothing without them. But here is the challenge for this week. The challenge is that I want you guys to draw a picture of your mom and dad. And if you want bonus points, maybe get your parents doing something they love. But I just want to challenge you guys to make it creative, make it fun, and we want to be able to show it off. Maybe you can write some words of appreciation because parents are totally awesome and they love you so much. They give you guys gifts, and not only that, they just love on you, and it'd be awesome to draw a cool picture. Now, if you guys are, you know, like have brothers and sisters in the Kid City, that's fine. You guys can all draw something a little different about your parents. But as an example, I want to show you a picture I drew of my parents, who I love. And here they are. That's my dad, my mom, they say. Oh, look at that. How interesting what they're both thinking. It's not amazing? Wow. I mean they can't both be wrong. So anyway, that's your challenge. Make sure you submit them to kidcity@citybaptist.ca and get your parents to help you do that, because your parents are awesome and it'll help you do that. Okay. Alright. Can't wait to see them, guys. Bye.
Man, that was awesome. I had a great time this week, kids. And that singing, man, that was phenomenal. That lesson touched my heart. And that challenge, I'm going to do that, Brandon. How about you?
Oh, man, I'm going to try it too. I wish I was a kid. Seriously, guys, though, please get in your weekly challenges this week, okay? Just to remind you guys, we have prizes, okay? We're going to announce a prize winner every week. And nice. At the end of all of this, we're going to have a grand prize winner with the kid with the most votes, okay?
I'm going to win. If it's your first time this week tuning in, I hope you come back next week and tune in for the next lesson. And if you have questions or comments, please do reach out to us at kidcity@citybaptist.ca. We miss you guys. I hope you have a good week. We love you.
And see you guys next time.